you have a series from n equal 2 to infinity, n times n minus 1, cn x to the n, plus 2 times the series from n equal 2 to infinity, n times n minus 1, cn x to the n minus 2, plus 3 times the series from n equal 1 to infinity, n cn x to the n. Okay? So, there's two main things to do in doing this here. What you're going to do first, and you want to do this first, is you want to do what's called running out terms. So you want the power series to start with the same power. So if I look at the first one, n starts at 2. So when I plug in 2, I get x squared. N is 2 in the second one. So when I plug that in, I get x to the 0. I plug in 1 to the last one, I get x to the first. So the highest one we start with is x squared. So what you want to do is run out, we call it running out, terms until they all start at x squared, okay? So the first one starts at x squared, so we're going to leave it that way. So the first one I'm going to leave alone. Okay, and on the second one, so remember the highest power was x squared on the first one. The second one starts out at x to the 0. So you would have to do what's called running out two terms, x to the 0 and x to the first, before you get to x squared. So what you're going to do is you're going to plug in n equal 2, and don't forget there is a 2 out front. Now, what I'll often do in the future is probably just write it on the inside, because it's easier to see it that way. So if I plug in 2 here, I'm going to get 4, c sub 2, x to the 0, okay? I won't usually write x to the 0, I'll just leave it as 1, but for now I'm going to leave it there. We're at one more term, so I'm going to plug in 3. 3 times 2 is 6, times 2 is 12. We'll get 12c1x to the first power. Now the next term is going to be squared, which matches up with the first one, so we're going to leave that now as it is. Now I'm going to move the 2 inside, so you have 2n, n minus 1, cn x to the n minus 2. Now remember, we needed n equal 2 for this one, n equal 3 for this one, so now the series starts at 4 to infinity, because that's n equal 2, n equal 3, and then n equal 4, 5, 6, 7, up to infinity. Okay, that should be c3. So anyone have that? So n equal 3 should give me c3 there. Okay, so if I go to the next one, now this one starts at x to the first. So again, we need to get to x squared for all of them. So this one needs to have one term ran out. So I'm going to write down below here, because you're not going to be able to see this. So below here, I'm going to have plus. Now n equal 1 would give me, again, the 3 is out front. So again, I'll be putting it on the inside from here on out. If I plug in 1, you're going to get 3c1. Plus a series now starting at 3c1x, plus a series starting at 2 to infinity, n cn x to the n. So that's what's called running out terms. Okay, so the first thing you want to do is make sure all the power series start at the same power. We'll fix the index in our next step. So if you look at it, when you plug in 2, you'll get x squared for the first one. When I plug in 4, I'll get x squared for the second one. When I plug in 2, I'll get x squared for the last one, okay? So they all start at x squared now. That does bring us to our next consideration, though. To put them together, they have to start at the same value of n. So if I look at the series here, I have n equal 2. I have n equal 4, and I have n equal 2. So it would make most sense to re-index them all to start at 2, because two of them already start at 2. You can re-index them to any number you want. But usually I pick the one that I have to change the least number of, and that would be n equal 4 is the only one that does not start at 2. You know what, maybe I'll do this, because I don't want you guys to lose track of each step here. Okay, so I'm going to leave this first one alone because it already starts at 2. Then we'll have 4c2 plus 12c3x. All right, so let's talk about the idea of reindexing. It's very, very, very simple. Your book makes it very, very hard, of course. To reindex it, you just make it what you want to. You guys are going to be saying this a million times. Make it what you want and fix it. So you're starting at 4, but we want to start at 2. Okay, so you're going to make it start at 2. And here's what you do. If you lower the index, in this case by 2, so I've gone from 4 to 2, you have to fix it. And you do the opposite to inside to all the ends. So the 2 is going to stay at 2. So since I decrease the 4 to 2, to compensate, I have to add 2 to the end. So plus 2 for this. Plus 2 for this gives me n plus 1. Plus 2 here gives me cn plus 2. And then plus 2 to this. So, you see how it works. So if n is 4 and I plug in 4, I wish to get 4 for that term right there. So when I plug in 2 into the first term, I should get 4, which I do, right? And 4, I get 4. Well, if I lower by 2, to get 2 more, I have to add 2. Same thing here, right? Plug in 4, I get 3. Plug in 2, I get 3. If I lower by 2, I have to add 2 to this term. So whatever you do to this, you do the opposite inside to each of the ends. Okay, now the rest is going to stay the same. So I'm going to have plus 3c1x plus the series starting at 2 to infinity and cn x to the n. Okay. Excuse me. Okay, let me kind of move this up a bit here so I go down the line here. All right, so now you're going to add the like terms. So we're going to be looking for essentially constant terms to start off with, okay? This is the only constant term I have. So we're going to put that by itself. So you have 4c2, okay? The next one will be x to the first. Now I look at this, I have this, and I have this. Okay, so you're going to factor out the x. You're going to have 12c3 plus 3c1 times x. Okay? So again, I have x to the 0 first one. The next term is x to the first. Now, everything else, x squared, x cubed, x to the 4th, can be obtained from the power series. And we can put all of them together because they all start out at x squared. And they all start with n, the same n, in this case, n equal 2. So what you would do here is you would write a series from n equal 2 to infinity. And what we're going to do here is we are going to factor out the x to the n and put it at the very end. Oh, so by the way, after you re-index, if they all start at the same value of n, all the x's should have the same power. And you see it's x to the n, x to the n, x to the n. If after you re-index, they do not start at the same power of x, then you did something wrong, okay? So we're going to put the x to the n at the end, just like we did here, since the x is the 0 and x to the first. So here we're going to have n, n minus 1 cn. Okay, that's from this one right here. From this one here, we're going to take this part right here, okay? So the 2n plus 1, n plus 2, cn plus 2.
Oh, I just figured out something.
So everyone see right here? There should be a 3 right here. This is why I need different color. I need to get different color pens here. But everyone kind of watch where my finger is. There should be a 3 there, first off. Okay. And then, of course, down here, there should be a 3 here as well. So then the last one we're going to have here is the 3n cn. And outside we're going to have x to the n.
Okay, that's the answer for this problem. I'll see you next time.